in over 100 countries, in 7 different languages, to more than a half billion viewers each week. The World Wrestling Federation, the worldwide leader in sports entertainment.
Perhaps 24 of the most exciting hours of World Wrestling Federation history this past weekend and past Monday night. And we'll talk all about it right here on The Out.
Yeah, we'll show you the crowning of a new WWF champion and how a Stone Cold Steve Austin spent his first night as champ.
His opponent from Roscoe, Texas, weighing 282 pounds, Bradshaw.
Speaking of Stone Cold, I wonder if Bradshaw's ever done any bail bondsman work.
I'll tell you what, this is one angry Texan, and there he is with a big old bull rope, and Savio Vega heading to higher ground.
Both Bradshaw and Savio were on teams that did not get the job done at the 15-team Battle Royal. Swept under a wave of momentum thanks to the return of the Legion of Doom, led by their new manager, Sonny.
That's right, the LOD returning at WrestleMania, winning the Battle Royal. New attitude, new costume, and here's Bradshaw with a mean old attitude going after Savio Vega. Vega tossed back into the ring, and here comes the 300-pound Texan, but Savio Vega from Los Periquas goes to work.
Savio Vega, and this is going to be a slugfest between he and Bradshaw, I can tell you that right now.
Headbutt by Savio Vega. And there's the big
LOD
right hand.
LOD 2000, Michael Cole. How about that, led by Sonny?
Yeah, and LOD 2000 is a shot at the WWF Tag Team Champions at Unforgiven In Your House a bit later this month as Bradshaw now and Savio Vega hammer away. And there's the big boot by the big Texan. Here's the reversal now. Bradshaw into the corner. Oh, and he catches Vega with an elbow. Bradshaw, look out, misses with a clothesline. There's the boot to the face.
Boy, luckily for Vega, he got out of the way of that lariat.
He didn't get out of the way of that one, though. Big clothesline knocking Vega out of the ring. Tell you what, Bradshaw has been on a major roll as of late here in the WWF, really making a name for himself. Savio Vega as well. This should be a tremendous matchup to kick things off on Shotgun. Later on in the program, the Headbangers in action against Brian Christopher and Scott Taylor. Plus, we will show you the restructuring of D-Generation X. What a story that is.
Certainly is. It has sent shockwaves throughout the wrestling world, and many people say that this past Monday changed the momentum in the war that is the wrestling industry.
We'll get into all that a bit later on, as Bradshaw now is in total control of the leader of Los Padillas, with Savio Vega. Bradshaw with a big kick beneath the, between the shoulder blades.
Bradshaw is just going to hit and pound on you as much as he can. Savio Vega's left arm could wind up in Bradshaw's trophy case.
We were talking about LOD, Kevin, coming up in Doc Hendrick's Slam Jam. We're going to hear some comments from the LOD 2000, so stick around. And Bradshaw,
will we get to see Sonny in that outfit?
I hope so.
Wow.
Sonny bringing the Legion of Doom back together again. And here is Bradshaw. Speaking of Los Periquas, did you see the way LOD dismantled Jose Estrada and Jesus Castillo this past week on Raw?
I mean, it just took a couple of minutes, and certainly the Legion of Doom needed something like this. And I guess Sonny was the woman to get the job done, and she went and reformed the Legion of Doom, now geared and ready to go for the new millennium.
Look at the strength by Savio Vega. Nice counter that time, and Bradshaw, though, with a sweep of the leg. Still working on that left arm of Savio Vega.
That's nice by Bradshaw, going back a shoulder breaker type maneuver there, driving the point of the shoulder down to the canvas.
And here's the cover now by Bradshaw, 2 kick out by Vega.
Bradshaw has focused his attack on the left arm of Savio Vega, and he's also kept Savio from using his martial arts tactics.
How far could Bradshaw go here in the WWF?
The sky's the limit. Any man 6'6", 293 pounds with that much raw ability, really, it's an open book. It's up to him if he can stay healthy. He has everything in his favor.
Big left hand by Bradshaw now, hammering away at the midsection of the chest of Savio Vega. Vega, Irish whip across the ring, throwing into the corner, and there's the big kick.
But I'm telling you, Savio Vega is ready for the breakout.
Wow.
These next few months are very critical for the career of Savio Vega, and I've got a feeling he's planning a major move very soon.
Major move meaning what?
Straight up the charts, straight up the rankings. It's time for Savio Vega to shine, perhaps on his own. I think the recent problems within Los Barriquas have given Savio some time to perhaps reflect on his career.
Chinlock by Savio Vega, and he's now in control of Bradshaw.
I mean, who would have thought? Let's talk about Degeneration X for a moment while we can. We'll show you what exactly transpired this past Monday. But the loss of at WrestleMania 14 by Shawn Michaels, certainly that put Degeneration X in some trouble. But in less than 24 hours, Degeneration X completely reformed, revitalized with new members, and stronger than ever, a very dangerous force.
Triple H said he went back to the blood, to the heart and soul. More on that a bit later on. And Savio Vega now putting on a wrestling clinic. What a chop. Wow.
There's the martial arts tactics, but Bradshaw up to the task.
Savio now with the big right hand up underneath the chin. Bradshaw in trouble. And what about the new WWF champion, Stone Cold Steve Austin?
Yeah, we're going to show you exactly how Stone Cold Steve Austin spent his first night as WWF champion. He and Vince McMahon collided once again. The corporate molding that is the WWF champion, I don't think is going the way Vince wants it.
Here's the cover by Savio, only one before the big Texan kicks out.
You know what, though? We've got to send out congratulations to not only Stone Cold Steve Austin, but also to Shawn Michaels for what was a Herculean match at WrestleMania 14. Shawn Michaels was in agony throughout that match, Michael, and he did his best, went further than many people gave him credit for, but Stone Cold Steve Austin came out on top.
And here comes Bradshaw now, hammering away with the elbow to the midsection of Savio Vega. Oh, big knee.
Boy, the worldwide press, the mainstream media came out in force to cover WrestleMania 14. And originally Mike Tyson was the big story as far as the mainstream press was concerned. But they all left singing a different tune, no longer looking down their nose at the World Wrestling Federation, garnering front page coverage on even the New York Times. A real highbrow publication that has done its best to degrade the WWF in its history. Now, I think Mike Tyson's future could be in the World Wrestling Federation. I think Mike Tyson could be done with boxing, and in my own opinion, I wouldn't be surprised if we see Iron Mike back in the WWF very soon.
I had the opportunity to attend the press conference after WrestleMania 14. That question was posed to Iron Mike Tyson. Would you come back to the World Wrestling Federation? He said he'd love to.
And I'll tell you what, all the fans that tuned in on the internet for the first Backstage Mania, I gotta thank you. What a record night it was on the WWF's website, www.wwf.com.
And here's Bradshaw now, trying to battle back. Whips Vega into the ropes, misses with the right hand. Here's Savio now, ducks underneath again. Uh-oh, look out, look at the strength of Bradshaw.
Are you kidding me?
Wow!
Fall away slam. Bradshaw had been taking a beating from Savio Vega, but mustered up the strength to give that desperation maneuver.
It was a desperation maneuver, but now Bradshaw tries to catch his breath, tries to gain some momentum from this capacity crowd this week on shotgun. Here we go now. Nice suplex. Vega's in trouble.
Belly-to-back suplex, and Bradshaw's going to look to end things here with the lariat very soon on the leader of Los Barriquas.
Bradshaw backs Vega into the ropes, whips him across the ring. There's a big boot to the face. Savio seeing stars. Crowd really into it this week. Nothing like seeing the WWF live. Savio now. Here's the reversal. Bradshaw into the corner. Ducks out. Look out. Lariat. That should be it. Bradshaw hooks the leg. It's over. The Texan wins.
I bet if Barry Windham was checking out a monitor in the locker room area, he got an eyeful right here in our first match on shotgun.
Hi again, everybody. What a big win for the big Texan Bradshaw. But a bit later on, we're going to talk about another ornery Texan.
We certainly will. The latest run-in with Stone Cold Steve Austin and Vince McMahon cost the new WWF champion a night in jail.
As Bradshaw heads back to the locker room area, time now to head to Doc Hendrick.
And Slam Jam.
Hello, everybody.
everybody. Come on inside. Welcome to WWF Slam Jam. Handsome Doc, the doc that rocks. And I got to tell you, I rocked my voice right out of my throat, hollering and screaming and having the time of my life at the greatest pay-per-view extravaganza of all time, WrestleMania 14, this past Sunday. It feels so good. We hyped this event and hyped it, and it far exceeded any hype we could have ever done. It was the bomb. Plain and simple. Now, I know that you know we have a brand new WWF champion in the form of a rattlesnake, Stone Cold Steve Austin. And what about the enforcer on the outside of the ring, Iron Mike Tyson? And how about that knockout punch to the former champion, Shawn Michaels? So many things happened at WrestleMania, like the re-emergence of Animal and Hawk. They have a new manager, Sonny. They are now LOD 2000.
New Age Outlaws, our time has come and your time is up.
That's right, New Age Outlaws. At WrestleMania, we went through 14 other teams to get to this shot. And on In Your House, Unforgiven, what a perfect name! Because it was Unforgiven! What you tried to do to me, trying to powerbomb me through the monitors, through the tables. It was Unforgiven! What you tried to do to my partner, shaving off his mohawk. It was Unforgiven! You stole the WWF Championships, our prize position, from us! And it's Unforgiven! What you think you could possibly do to us? That's Unforgiven! Because we're not just Legion of Doom! We have Sonny now, and we are LOD 2000!
Tell him, Hawk.
Yeah! What a rush! Wow, what a new look and a good look! All right, when we come back on Slam Jam, we will hear from the People's Intercontinental Champion, The Rock.
Still to come on Shotgun, the former NWA World Tag Team Champions, the Headbangers, take on Too Sexy, Brian Christopher, and Scott Taylor. What a matchup! Plus, the stunning confrontation between Stone Cold and the WWF owner, Vince McMahon. But up next, we'll see how Triple H began the restructuring of DX.
All I ever wanted was to be loved, but people just want to abuse me. They want to kick me and throw me around. It makes me so mad, I just want to squeeze the life out of someone.
WWF Slammers, they've got the moves. Available at toy stores everywhere.
So, trying to squeeze 6 months of physics into an all-night cramathon? This will get your protons moving. Just when you're losing that kinetic energy, bang! Knock ball to the mouth. You got that, Einstein?
Starburst fruit juice. It's Einstein.
Thank you. Today, people who didn't send the money, Western Union, and the heartbreak it caused. Why the disguise, mystery guest?
I blew it.
Can you share with us?
My mom needed money, and...
And you didn't use Western Union.
Right. So to get the money, she had to hitchhike across three counties. Right. Took two pickups and an 18-wheeler.
That's no way to treat your mama, man.
And how does mom feel? My own son.
Hey, it's your money. Use Western Union, the fastest way to send money worldwide.
It's no secret that perspiration and stress can lead to breakouts.
Sorry.
But right now, that's the last thing on Sarah's mind. She uses Triple Action Stridex to deal with zits. Stridex fights zits three ways, so Sarah can worry about more important things. Stridex. Deal with it.
Nestle Flips. They're completely irresistible.
Ooh. I'm just going to take two, in case I lose one.
Roll Gold Pretzels and Nestle Milk Chocolate.
I'll just eat the broken ones.
Nestle Flips. What's your excuse?
Hi there.
Hello.
Now, you want to be shocked and amazed by our psychics, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Well, this time, it's me who's going to shock and amaze you.
Oh, really?
Yes, really. I'm giving you 12 full minutes with a real psychic for free.
12 full minutes? All in one call?
Yes, all in one call. No strings attached. This 12 free minutes is for real.
And do I have to join a club or something?
No, this free is better than free. In fact, you're under no obligation to spend a single dime, and you will definitely get your 12 minutes free.
Well, it sounds pretty good.
Honey, listen to me. This is so free that you speak directly to your psychic on an 800 number.
On an 800 number? Wow, it really is free.
Exactly. So don't miss out. Pick up your phone and call this number right now. Get your free psychic reading with 12 full minutes free.
Call now for the best long-distance rate and get 12 minutes free. Speak to your psychic directly through an 800 number. This psychic reading really is free.
Call 1-800-860-9849.
Here's a Kleenex, Michael.
I'll tell you what, we're back on Shotgun, and Kevin, that means a lot to me. I was brought up watching those guys.
I was too. A lot of fans were.
And here they come on their beautiful Titan motorcycles. Skull and 8-Ball, the DOA. That's a piece of Americana right there.
You know, our ring announcer, Howard Finkel, looks awfully nervous with these Titan bikes around.
Yeah, I was waiting for a ring announcer to announce these guys. And a little sweat on Howard's brow up there. Tag team action, folks, the DOA against Brian Walsh and Roy Raymond. And I'll tell you what, this team here, the DOA, is going to be a force to be reckoned with in the near future in the WWF.
They certainly are. There are great things ahead. A lot of people know Chains, the leader of the DOA, certainly a singular force to be reckoned with. Skull and 8-Ball, very impressive. But Chains was dismantled by Kurgan this past week. I mean, people have taken Kurgan lightly, and they've laughed at the shackles. I think after Kurgan's win over Chains this past Monday, you can take the giant lightly no more. Hey, Howard! Howard!
Hello?
Who's... You want to do some ring announcing, Howard? Never mind. Folks, I'll do Howard's job.
Roy Raymond and Brian Walsh. You did that pretty good, Kev.
Thanks.
There's the bell. We're set for action. At least the timekeeper's awake. And Brian Walsh now will start off against the Skull from the DOA. And they're identical twins as this crowd really starting to get behind DOA. Skull backing Walsh into the corner. There's the kick to the midsection now. DOA straight ahead, aggressive.
A real no-frills team. They come right at you.
Walsh off the ropes now. Look at this.
Wow! What a spine buster right there. And certainly the DOA seizing momentum. And I've got a feeling that there's a lot of big things in the future for the DOA. Tag now made.
Here's the double team by Skull and 8-Ball. Big boot to the face of Brian Walsh.
But Brian Walsh desperately needs to make a tag. Skull and 8-Ball just manhandled so far.
Look at that. 8-Ball hammering away now and Walsh in the corner.
This is ugly.
No match for DOA. Irish rip across the ring into the corner. Now, oh, follows it up with a big forearm. Walsh face first into the mat. He's in la-la land. DOA just so physical, so large, and there goes Walsh outside the ring.
Yeah, just like the Paula Jones lawsuit, thrown out.
And here comes Skull and 8-Ball now. Uh-oh, they're calling him. Then Walsh across the way. Oh, my, right into that barricade. Woo-hoo. Folks, more of this matchup with Shotgun continue.
Can we get a mop for Brian Walsh?
Your room, Grammy, and there's the phone. Feel free.
But your phone bill.
Oh, don't be silly. Just dial 10321 first.
Why?
It saves me money.
Well, maybe a few quick calls.
Good. 10321 saves on quick calls.
I won't talk long.
No, talk all you want. It saves 50% off calls over 20 minutes.
I won't call far.
Call anywhere. International rates are great, too. Just dial 10321, then the number as usual. Anything else?
Privacy would be nice.
So, trying to squeeze 6 months of physics into an all-night cramathon? Boys, what are you thinking? This will get your protons and neutrons going. Because just when you start to feel your kinetic energy go...
Bang! Dodgeball to the mouth.
You got that, Einstein?
Starburst fruit juice. The flavor's a bang, a burst. Need a boost? Give it some juice.
It's Einstein.
It's the way you've always wanted your hair to look, naturally. Introducing GHT.
Excellent. At last, a hair replacement process that eliminates the appearance of hair loss without doctors, surgery, or topical solutions. It's the safest hair replacement discovery in nearly 50 years. It's GHT, genetic hair transfusion. Now you can restore your hair all in one day or over a period of several days or weeks. The choice is yours.
First introduced by the motion picture industry, GHT was created to conceal hair loss even under revealing close-up camera shots. Now, Keith's Hair Center in Green Bay and Appleton introduces the hair replacement system that can restore your hair to its natural feeling and natural appearance. For more information on the new, safe, non-surgical approach to restoring your hair for life, call Keith's Hair Center now. GHT, it's what you want your hair to be, naturally.
We're back on Shotgun. Brian Walsh is being manhandled by DOA, and here comes Skull into the ring. Hammering away.
Excellent teamwork as well. They've done a great job of isolating Brian Walsh. Roy Raymond hasn't even made a tag.
Look at Walsh now. There's the crossbody. Here's the cover. Only one. Kick out with authority, and here comes Roy Raymond, immediately met by the boot of Skull. It's been some week in the World Wrestling Federation as you see the strength now in the DOA. There's the shoulder breaker. And there's an elbow into the sternum. A second one. Is he going to go for a third? And he does.
Absolutely dominating.
What about the colossal matchup at WrestleMania? Brother versus brother, The Undertaker versus Kane.
Taker got the win, but he absorbed a tremendous amount of punishment. I don't think The Undertaker physically will ever be the same.
And I also understand that there's a possibility now, and we could find out this week. Oh, what a clothesline. We could find out this week on Raw whether The Undertaker will accept. Here's a cover by DOA. Raymond kicks out. We could find out if The Undertaker will accept the challenge from Kane and Paul Bearer for an inferno match at Unforgiven.
I can only imagine what an inferno match is all about. I mean, it's enough to give you nightmares.
And the WWF magazine, a big feature on The Undertaker this month.
Yeah, Undertaker's on the cover. It hits newsstands this Tuesday. A story inside about Paul Bearer. There's some questions that need to be asked of Paul Bearer about his involvement in the lives of Kane and The Undertaker.
DOA now power slam by 8-Ball. With authority. And look at this now. DOA just straight ahead aggressiveness.
Really sending out a message to all the tag teams, including the New Age Outlaws, the WWF Tag Team Champions, and newest members of DX.
Yeah, talking about sending out a message, Triple H sending a message to the World Wrestling Federation that he is in charge now of the hottest group in all of sports entertainment, DX.
Yeah, well, Triple H came out on Raw this past week and fired Mike Tyson. Yeah, right. And then went ahead to kind of put Shawn Michaels aside. And that certainly has left a lot of questions unanswered about Shawn Michaels' future in the WWF and DX.
Yeah, what about the latest member of D-Generation X, along with the New Age Outlaws, X-Pac?
Well, X-Pac's reception certainly was...
covered by DOA 2 and Raymond with a kickout.
I mean, it certainly was a tremendous reception, but let me tell you, this is no fan favorite. This is not going to be some young man you want to cheer. D-Generation X is going to do everything that they can to try to destroy tradition and try to ruin the World Wrestling Federation.
You want some of this?
And I want to...
Wow.
DOA in control. I want to know what's going on with Shawn Michaels and DX. I mean, Triple H said he dropped the ball. Shawn Michaels dropped the ball at WrestleMania and lost the title to Stone Cold.
Well, I understand that right now on the WWF Superstar line, on option 3 in the Ross Report, Jim Ross has the latest status of Shawn Michaels in regards to his future in DX and the WWF. Call 1-900-737-4WWF. Appropriate charges applied. Consider 18. Get your parents' permission before calling.
Any ideas?
I'm not really sure. I mean, it's obvious to me he's out of DX, and I've got to wonder what the future holds for him in the WWF. I guess we're going to have to call JR.
Yeah, Brian Walsh just hit his head on the stairs. DOA in total control. Boot to the side of the head now of Roy Raymond. I really think that this team will be tag team champions in the near future.
LOD gets the first chance of the tag team champions, April 26th at Unforgiven. But DOA is looking very strong, and certainly they have to be considered for a title opportunity.
Hammering away now. This is 8-Ball. And look on the outside. Oh, wow! That has got to hurt. Woo! Brian Walsh.
Brian Walsh has got to wonder why he got out of bed this morning right about now.
DOA in foul moods. There's the double team. Oh, a double TDT. Here's the cover now. Hooks the leg. It's over. Skull and 8-Ball victorious.
Here are your winners. Skull and 8-Ball, the disciples of Unforgiven.
There's Howard. Tell you what, the DOA on a major roll as of late. Straight ahead, aggressive, in-your-face wrestling. Folks, time now for Slam Jam. Here's handsome Doc Hendrix.
Born to be wild, and what a wild time we're having here on WWF Slam Jam. What a wild time we had at the greatest pay-per-view extravaganza of all time, WrestleMania 14. And we've got a wild new champion, the Rattlesnake Stone Cold Steve Austin. But I gotta tell you, that was quite a matchup between Austin and Shawn Michaels, a competitive matchup that went back and forth, take nothing away from Shawn Michaels. And what about the auspicious first day Stone Cold had as WWF champion in jail, thanks to the World Wrestling Federation owner, Vince McMahon? More on that a little bit later here on Shotgun. Let's switch gears and talk about the Intercontinental Champion. It's still The Rock. Ken Shamrock had won the title, but his own worst enemy, his temper, was his downfall. Now here he is, The Rock.
It's about time you guys got here. You realize that the People's Champ has got something to say, do you? Well, now he's going to say it. Kenny, 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 when are you going to realize that The Rock and all The Rock's fans are tired of hearing you complain? You talk about how The Rock walked away not once but twice with your Intercontinental title. Well, you've got half a brain, obviously, because he did walk away once and twice. He walked away with his Intercontinental title. So Ken Shamrock, come in your house at Unforgiven. If you really think you're going to be ready for The Rock, then The Rock wants you to come correct and bring it, because he's going to be waiting.
Ladies and gentlemen, I don't think The Rock has seen the last of the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock. And did you see that mixed tag match at WrestleMania 14? An unbelievable amount of athleticism displayed by both ladies, Luna and especially Sable. But what about Luna's challenge this past week on Raw? An evening gown match, April 26th at Unforgiven, in your house. And the only way to win is strip your competitor down to her bra and panties. I don't mind telling you, at In Your House, I'm rooting for nobody but Luna.
I'm with you on that one, Doc. And speaking of dresses, the Headbangers are in action.
And up next, Vince McMahon shows Stone Cold how to do things the hard way.
You think you're ready for the School of Hard Knocks? SCU is now accepting applications. You must possess strong language skills.
I will whip your ass, and that's the bottom line.
A firm grasp of political incorrectness.
To me, it's a bunch of crap.
The ability to use sign language.
Oh, hell yeah!
Plus, have a knack for physical education. To enroll in his championship program, you need this limited edition 100% cotton Stone Cold University t-shirt. To order, call 815-734-1161 or send $25 plus shipping and handling to the address on your screen. Learn from the champion, Professor Austin. Graduate from the class of 316.
It's a scorching 98.6 degrees inside your mouth.
Yeah!
But inside a winter fresh mouth?
Tastes much, much cooler, yeah.
Winter fresh gum from Wrigley's.
I see cool flavor, I see cool breath.
It's gonna last and last and last. Try winter fresh gum from Wrigley's for icy cool breath that lasts.
So, trying to squeeze 6 months of physics into an all-night cramathon? Boys, what are you thinking? This will get your protons and neutrons going. Because just when you start to feel your kinetic energy go, bang! Dodgeball to the mouth. You got that, Einstein?
Starburst fruit juice. The flavor's a bang, a burst. Need a boost? Give it some juice.
With Einstein.
Wesley Snipes, Woody Harrelson, Jennifer Lopez. Beneath the streets, they're the cops who rule the rails.
You're not going to hit him.
Why not?
Because I'm going to hit him.
Playing by the only rules they know.
When this is over with, remind me to knock you out.
A network premiere. The Money Train is coming. Tuesday at 8, 7 Central on Fox. Get on board or get out of the way.
If you see breaking news, call Fox 11 at 1-800-236-TIPS. Or from your Cellular One phone, press star TV 11.
Let me ask you a question. What's the easiest way to prevent over 200,000 car truck crashes a year? Here's the deal. Trucks need lots of room to turn right. That's why they swing left first. It's not an invitation to pass. When the car does try to squeeze by, it enters the right no zone, the truck driver's biggest blind spot. Crashes like this happen every 3 minutes. Drive smart. Don't hang out in the no zone.
Welcome back to Shotgun, everybody. Tag team action.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Approaching the ring, introducing first, at a total combined weight of 422 pounds, the team of two sexy, Ryan Christopher and Scott Miller.
Now this is what sexy looks like, baby.
And that's what sexy looks like. Anyway. Two light heavyweights, Scott Taylor and Brian Christopher, teaming up. Going to have their hands full this week. Speaking of having their hands full, I think WWE owner Vince McMahon has his hands full.
I don't know. Maybe Vince has finally gotten his way. You think so? What we said a little bit earlier on, folks, is true. Apparently, Vince has gotten Stone Cold Steve Austin to agree to his request to become a respectful WWF champion. From what I understand, we're going to see Vince's version of respectable Stone Cold Steve Austin as WWF champion this Monday on Raw.
And here come the former NWA World Tag Team Champions, the Headbangers, losing the belts this past week on Raw to the Midnight Express.
Well, they certainly were game champions. The Midnight Express really came together. But what about Dan the Beast Severn? Sat there in his double-breasted sport coat, didn't show one ounce of emotion until he got up at the completion of the match and absolutely stretched Mosh and Thrasher. I mean, you want to talk about a submission specialist. It's Dan the Beast Severn.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, I understand James E. Cornette telling me a bit earlier this week that Dan Severn will make his debut on Raw this Monday.
He is the NWA World Heavyweight Champion, and you will see an array of gold on this man like no other, holding titles in many, many different classes.
Also on Raw this Monday, The Rock will defend the Intercontinental title against Owen Hart.
Talk about The Rock. What a shameful performance by he and the other members of the Nation of Domination, turning their back on their leader, Farouk. I mean, Farouk is no angel, but
Mosh
no
down.
One deserves that kind of treatment.
Mosh locking up in the center of the ring with Too Sexy. Nice slam that time by Brian Christopher. It all started, really, a few months ago. Dissension building between The Rock and Farouk within the Nation came to a head at WrestleMania.
Certainly did. Farouk did not assist The Rock getting out of the ankle lock submission. Then the following night on Raw, everything appeared to be copacetic. And The Rock said he had made a mistake and had learned his lesson. It was just a trap, though, to get Farouk in the ring.
It was. The Rock and Farouk teaming up against Shamrock and the lethal weapon, Steve Blackman. And then the Nation and The Rock struck. And The Rock now calling himself the ruler of the Nation as opposed to the leader.
And I understand Farouk is going to be in the house this Monday on Raw. And watch out!
Oh, double team by the Headbanger!
Christopher and Taylor cut from the same cloth.
Here we go now. Double headbutt. And Brian Christopher in trouble. Thrasher whips him into the ropes. Here comes Mosh. Wow! These guys are students of tag team wrestling, the Headbangers. Here's the double team again. Another one! Taylor and Christopher. Seeing star double drop kick.
Oh, man. They are bouncing Taylor and Christopher all over the place.
Tell you what, the Headbangers have a score to settle with the Midnight Express and James E. Cornette. I don't think that feud's over. And Taylor and Christopher now yelling at Mosh and Thrasher. And Christopher didn't like Thrasher mocking him.
Well, there's a lot of emotion in this ring. And I'm telling you, you can feel it. It's getting set to heat up.
Shut up!
Christopher yelling at the crowd, folks. We got to take a quick break. We'll be back with the end of this matchup in just a moment.
On the next MASH...
Well, I see you are as clever as you are clean.
Okay, how does this hit you?
Boom!
Major Winchester finally gets pushed too far.
Don't worry, Charles. Every clout has a silver lining.
Fortunately, he makes friends with the one man who can teach him the finer points of self-defense.
Do you, charge by the hour?
Blue Blood becomes Black Belt. On the next MASH...
Weekdays at 5:30 on Fox 11.
It's the way you've always wanted your hair to look, naturally. Introducing GHT.
Excellent. At last, a hair replacement process that eliminates the appearance of hair loss without doctors, surgery, or topical solutions. It's the safest hair replacement discovery in nearly 50 years. It's GHT, genetic hair transfusion. Now you can restore your hair all in one day or over a period of several days or weeks. The choice is yours.
First introduced by the motion picture industry, GHT was created to conceal hair loss even under revealing close-up camera shots. Now, Keith's Hair Center in Green Bay and Appleton introduces the hair replacement system that can restore your hair to its natural feeling and natural appearance. For more information on the new, safe, non-surgical approach to restoring your hair for life, call Keith's Hair Center now. GHT, it's what you want your hair to be, naturally.
WLUK Fox 11 has an immediate opening in accounts payable. This is a part-time position requiring 20 hours per week, Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Qualified candidates should have prior accounts payable experience. Knowledge of MAS 90 software would be advantageous. In addition, the qualified person will be asked to assume some receptionist duties. WLUK offers competitive wages and benefits, including paid vacation, holidays, and a 401k plan. Please send resume to the address on the screen.
Back on Shotgun, and Brian Christopher and Scott Taylor really doing well as a tag team, but there's a nice leg sweep by Mosh.
The Headbangers showing no ill effects, though, of their loss this past Monday of the NWA World Tag Team titles.
Thrasher now off the top ropes. Here's the double cross that left arm of Scott Taylor.
Hyperextending that arm from the shoulder to the wrist.
Speaking of dresses, you see the Headbangers wearing those dresses there.
Hey, they're skirts. Get it right.
Skirts, whatever. What about the evening gown match? It's coming up at Unforgiven, April 26th.
Well, Luna issued the challenge. Sable said anytime, anywhere.
Wow!
What a performance by Sable at WrestleMania 14. A lot of people said, Michael, she was just a pretty face. She proved to be a whole lot more.
Oh, she was unreal in that matchup as Mosh comes in now. Here's the double team by the Headbanger. Taylor off the rope. Oh, wow, slapjack. Look out. Taylor face first. And here comes Christopher.
Oh,
another one. Too sexy kissing the man. And there's a right hand. The Headbangers so skilled as tag team partners. Know each other's moves. So very, very well, they've held the WWF and the NWA tag team title. Mosh now a little bit of slam dancing. Wow. This coming week on Raw, we understand Luna's going to tune up for that evening gown match with a matchup against a man.
What?
That's right, a match against a man this Monday on Raw. Going to prove how tough Luna is.
Well, I guess you won't be her opponent.
Why do you say that?
Look at
anyway,
Scott Taylor.
Here we go. Scott Taylor in control. Hammer it away at Mosh.
So Luna is going to face a man this Monday on Raw.
That's
in preparation
right.
For the evening gown match.
Yeah, and we're also going to see perhaps a corporate Stone Cold. Speaking of Stone Cold, Mosh may be out cold after that drop kick to the face by Taylor.
I can't imagine Stone Cold Steve Austin going corporate, but that apparently, folks, is what's going to happen this Monday. And I know The Undertaker is going to have some words about Kane. Will he accept the challenge Paul Bearer issued for the Inferno match at Unforgiven on Sunday, April 26th?
Speaking of accepting the challenge, what about this team of Christopher and Taylor? Extremely impressive this week.
They've got a natural chemistry. Remember when Road Dogg and Billy Gunn first formed as a team? We saw that natural chemistry. I kind of see it here with these two.
Christopher down across the small of the back.
Well, you know what? I would have loved to have been a fly on the wall inside Titan Towers this past week with that meeting between Vince and Stone Cold. The rumors coming out of it that there will be a corporate Stone Cold as the WWF champion.
Here's Brian Christopher now. Into a quick cover. There's two. Just a kick out of 2.5 by Mosh.
Christopher needs to follow up. He's got the offense going. He needs to make some quick tags. He and Taylor can really shine here.
Taylor now tags in. Sets up. Oh! Shot to the ribs by Scott Taylor. There's that annoying laugh of Brian Christopher. Once again, though, Taylor seems to be taking way too much time here. Setting him up. Wow!
Woo! Almost a Greco-Roman-like throw.
And here's the cover by Taylor. Fails to hook the leg, and Mosh gets the shoulder up.
I bet we'll see a lot of throws like that from the Supreme Mat Specialist, Dan the Beast Severn, who will make his in-ring WWF debut this Monday on Raw.
Here's Mosh off the ropes now. Oh, they telegraphed it. There's the DDT. Desperation move, the double DDT by Mosh, and Christopher and Taylor in trouble. And Thrasher really wants to make a tag.
Masha's been absorbing a lot of punishment for quite some time. The arm extended. He makes the tag.
And here's Thrasher now. Big right hand. Another right hand. Lifts Christopher up, slams him to the canvas. Body slam of Scott Taylor. Clothesline. Another one. Thrasher is taking control of this matchup. Now all four men in the ring. And now Scott Taylor tries to battle back. Thrasher tossed outside the ring. Now it's two on one with Moss in trouble.
What an upset this would be if Taylor and Christopher get the victory over the former tag team champions, the Headbangers.
And Scott Taylor taking time as he heads up to the top ropes. Moss is in trouble. Look out. He ducks. Taylor hits Christopher. Taylor drop kicked his own partner. And now they're in trouble. Here's Thrasher up on the top ropes. Setting him up. Stage dive time. Look out. It's over. Thrasher hooks the leg. The Headbangers win.
Here are your winners, the Headbangers.
Certainly the experience of the Headbangers came through in the end, but I really saw a spark out of Taylor and Christopher.
The Headbangers pick up the victory. Kevin, we got to take a look at what happened at the end of this matchup.
Well, certainly the Headbangers had been on the receiving end for quite some time. And escape, though, a little miscommunication by Taylor and Christopher led to the stage dive. And a win for the Headbangers on shotgun.
And folks, don't forget Raw this Monday.
100 countries in 7 different languages to more than a half billion viewers each week. The World Wrestling Federation, the worldwide leader in sports entertainment.
Austin in that corporate kind of look. Plus, we've got huge news on Unforgiven, but right now, the light heavyweight champion. Plus, we've got huge news about Raw coming this Monday, Mike.
Can't
we'll
wait.
Talk more about that in the hour. I got a big scoop for everybody.
Nice arm drag takedown by Taka Michinoku. Taka, though, perhaps with eyes in the back of his head the past few weeks. Last time we saw him, he was attacked by a group that we now know calls themselves Club Kamikaze. What was that all about?
I don't really know, and I don't think Taka knows either.
Taka backed into the ropes, ripped off the ropes down by Taylor, over top of Scott Taylor. Taylor turns around, nice arm drag by the light heavyweight champion.
Scott Taylor impressed a lot of folks in a tag team matchup with Brian Christopher. Last week on Shotgun, they faced and lost to the Headbangers, but a lot of people now are talking about Taylor and Christopher as a team of the future, and certainly that's something for Taka to keep in mind.
I'll tell you what, this is a great opportunity for Scott Taylor to pull an upset this week over Taka Michinoku.
Well, Taka has so many things on his mind, though, right now. So many people gunning for that light heavyweight title.
Taylor off the ropes. Nice knockdown of Taka Michinoku. Outweighs him by about 20 pounds or so. Taylor at 214. Taka about 195. Big brought by Taka. Kicked to the midsection by Taylor. And now a big right
man.
Hand.
He really cracked him.
Ooh. What a chop by Taylor. And Taka really feeling it now. Taylor whips Taka into the ropes. Misses with the right hand. Wow, what a kick up underneath the chin.
When Taka elevates the pace, there's nobody better. Even Scott Taylor can't keep up with the light heavyweight champion.
Drop kick through the ropes. And Taka loves to work now when his opponent's outside the ring. And look out now. Taka from the second rope. Asai Muto, look out. What a move by Michinoku. He is such a high flyer. And Kevin, we'd be remiss if we don't take another look at this one.
The aerial artistry of the light heavyweight champion. Drilled Scott Taylor.
And now Taka's in control. Snap bear into the drop kick. Nice move by Taka Michinoku.
We're about 2 weeks away from Unforgiven, Michael. The world will be converging on Greensboro, North Carolina. A lot of focus and a lot of attention. We got a lot of big news about Unforgiven here in the hour.
Taka to the top ropes now. He's going to fly. Out of the way. Taka, I think he might have hurt his wrist on the fall that time. And now Taylor,
forget his wrist. How about his rib cage? I think he just caved himself in.
And Taylor now mocking the light heavyweight champion. There's the big right hand.
Well, I think Taylor has been hanging out with Brian Christopher. Some of that cockiness has been rubbing off on Taylor.
Gotta admit though, Scott Taylor is so dangerous.
He's in the best shape of his life. He's really prepared for this match.
Look at this now. Wow.
Fall away slam, almost a Greco-Roman type throw. Moves like this we'll see out of Dan Severn a little bit later on. The NWA World Champion is here in the World Wrestling Federation, and he means business.
In fact, a special look at Severn coming up next.
Oh.
Wow. Taylor off the ropes, now loses the drop kick into the chest. Taka really in trouble. And now Taylor's going to go for the cover. Hooks the leg, two, and Taka gets the shoulder up.
And I am psyched up about seeing LOD 2000. And your favorite part of that team is Sunny.
Yeah. Can't wait. There goes Taka now off the rope. Telegraphed by Taylor. Stuck deathly. Here's the cover. Two. Taylor kicks out. And there's the clothesline. I don't know how much Taka has left.
That's the added leg strength of Scott Taylor, able to kick out and then follow up quickly with that clothesline. The power of Taylor, even 20 pounds. When you're a light heavyweight, it means a lot.
Taylor quickly to his feet, lifts Taka up. Nice suplex that time. Taylor taking his time on the cover. There it is, two and a kick out again.
Boy, there's so much talk in the World Wrestling Federation right now about Stone Cold Steve Austin and Vince McMahon. And folks, oh, wait a minute, submission move.
He's got the arm and the ankle locked up.
He's got the arm bar, the leg right behind. This is a submission move. Will the champion submit?
You're going right inside the action there. You can hear Taylor screaming and talking. Now he releases the hold and puts the elbow into the back. And there's another one. Taylor's so aggressive lately. Rolls Taka over. Here's the cover. We can have kick out by Taka.
He should have hooked the leg there. Taylor has wrestled just about a perfect match. Perhaps that his first mistake.
Michinoku backed into the ropes. Whipped off the ropes now. Ducks underneath the right hand. Wow, what a slam by Scott Taylor. Again a cover. Again, Taka kicks out.
To go back to talk about Stone Cold and Vince for a minute, folks, a little later on in the hour, we've got a huge announcement about Raw this Monday, live from Philadelphia, the Core State Center. Vince McMahon, Stone Cold Steve Austin. The story didn't end last week.
Irish whip into the corner. Taka felt that one, and Taylor follows up with the right hand.
I mean, we'll see Stone Cold Steve Austin with that corporate look, as I said, a little later on. And, folks, it was just a wild scene this past Monday.
Reversal, and now Taka takes control. Knee up underneath the chin. Taka's going to fly from the top ropes. Taylor turns around, drop kick. Wow! And now Michinoku calls for the Michinoku driver. Perhaps one of the most devastating finishing moves in all the WWF. He's got Taylor up. Nice counter by Taylor. Kick to the midsection. Taka off the ropes. Taylor goes for the slam. Can't get it. Taka now. There it is. The Michinoku driver hooks the leg. It's over. Taka wins. Taka wins.
Here is your winner, the World Wrestling Federation Light Heavyweight Champion, Taka Michinoku.
On his crowd is on his feet. Electrifying performance by the Light Heavyweight Champion. And what a gusty effort by Scott Taylor, who's improving by leaps and bounds.
Look out!
Turn around!
Right in front of us! Club Kamikaze!
Where do they come from?
They're attacking Taka, who just went through a grueling 10-minute match. Wow! We know this group is from Japan. That's where Taka's from. We don't know if this is some sort of personal feud or not.
They competed together in Michinoku Pro.
Kamikaze! And now they slap the face of Taka Michinoku. And they head back into the crowd. What do you make of all this, Kevin?
Oh, boy, that's the story right there. Taka victimized once again by Club Kamikaze. I understand we've got a shot of where Club Kamikaze came from. Out from the crowd. And they struck with vengeance a second time. I mean, this attack is savage. And look.
Wow.
Oh my.
And there's Taka Michinoku now.
Oh, he's in a bad way.
WWF officials, referees in the ring, checking on the light heavyweight champion. I'll tell you what, Taka not only has to deal with the many wrestlers who are targeting him, trying to win the championship from Taka, but now he has to worry about this club kamikaze, a gang of rogues.
When will they strike again? And who's next? Don't think Taka isn't the only name on their list. These guys mean business.
Taka won the battle. He may have lost the war.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to WWF Slam Jam. Man, that is the second time we have seen Taka Michinoku ambushed by Club Kamikaze. Kind of makes you wonder why. Well, you don't have to wonder about the next World Wrestling Federation pay-per-view spectacular. It is Unforgiven in your house Sunday, April 26th. That is just 2 weeks away. And we will see the brand new WWF champion, Stone Cold Steve Austin, make his first pay-per-view title defense. And hopefully this Monday on Raw, we will find out who Stone Cold's opponent will be. In addition to that, the WWF Tag Team titles will be on the line as the New Age Outlaws defend against LOD 2000, who got this title shot by virtue of their victory at WrestleMania in the 15-team over-the-top rope battle royal. But everyone is so curious about the first ever Inferno match. Brother versus brother, The Undertaker against Kane, and adding fuel to the fire, standing by right now, Paul Bearer and Kane.
Oh, dead man, what a grand time we had. What a grand time we had at the graveside of your poor mama and daddy. Oh, it was so wonderful. Yes, the fire, the barbecue. And now, in your house, Unforgiven, Inferno, there'll be another fire. Yes, my dream will come true. A ring of fire around the ring. The first one to catch fire loses. It's your turn.
Mm-mm-mm. Now, my sources tell me the Undertaker was so upset after his parents' gravesite got destroyed by Paul Bearer and Kane. Well, there's no telling what he will do this Monday on Raw Live. And what will happen in the first ever evening gown matchup between Sable and Luna, where the only way you can win is to strip your opponent down to her undergarments? It all happens at Unforgiven in your house, April 26th.
Brought to you by Starburst Fruit Chews. Need a boost? Give it some juice.
And by WWF The Music Volume 2. Experience your favorite WWF original jams, now available in stores.
Still to come on Shotgun, the Shotgun debut of the LOD 2000. Sonny will be in their corner.
And up next, the world's greatest entertainer, singer, wrestler, Double J, is on the scene.
It's a scorching 98.6 degrees inside your mouth.
Yeah!
But inside a Winter Fresh mouth?
Tastes much, much cooler, yeah.
Winter Fresh gum from Wrigley's.
I see cool flavor, I see cool breath.
It's going to last and last and last. Try Winter Fresh gum from Wrigley's for icy cool breath that lasts.
Hey, want to play Bop It?
Cool.
It commands you obey.
Bop it. Twist it. Half it.
If you can't keep up,
twist it.
You lose. Once you get your hands on Bop It, you're not going to want to stop it. Fast talking electronic Bop It. Batteries not included.
So, trying to squeeze 6 months of physics into an all-night cramathon? This will get your protons moving. Just when you're losing that kinetic energy, bang! Dodgeball to the mouth. You got that, Einstein?
Starburst Fruit Juice.
It's Einstein.
Nobody brings you local election results like your home team, Fox 11. First on Fox with faster results.
We begin tonight in Ashwaubenon, where the voters say no, at least for now.
First on Fox with more live coverage and more local reaction.
We realized that there was time for change.
Fox 11 goes farther and informs you faster than any other station can. We're your home team for local election coverage. WLUK Fox 11.
It's a bike ride to raise money for the American Diabetes Association. And it's called Tour de Cure. This will be my third year. I do it because I get a great workout, and you feel good about doing something for someone else.
Ha!
Yeah, I get tired. There's someone behind me whispering in my ear.
You can do it.
I need you.
Come on, legs.
My father had diabetes. How far would I go to help someone else? How long is the road?
the promoter
is
for Double J.
With a 20-minute time limit. Coming down the aisle from the beautiful Volunteer State, the world's greatest promoter, Tennessee Lee.
Tell you what, Tennessee Lee really has Double J on a roll. In fact, Double J owns the only pinfall victory over Steve Blackman here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Yeah, don't think that the WWF's lethal weapon isn't looking for Double J.
All right, folks,
we could see it here. Who knows?
Again. Have you get up on your feet here and show respect.
Please.
I'm going to introduce the greatest star of all. He's the very versatile, the multi-dimensional. That's right, folks. He's J-E-double-F, J-A-double-R, E-double-T. It's Double J, Jeff Jarrett. Ain't he great?
And what about the big news for Unforgiven in your house in just 2 weeks from Greensboro, North Carolina on pay-per-view? The country band Sawyer Brown will play backup to Double J.
Oh, wait a minute. Isn't that kind of like the tail wagging the dog? We know Double J's singing resume is not too impressive.
Right, he's going to sing at Unforgiven, according to Double J and Tennessee Lee. And I'll tell you what, Sawyer Brown, they are no slouches. They've won a number of awards, Country Music Association awards. They've had some number one country records. They are the real deal.
Yeah, Some Girls Do is a fixture in my CD player. I love that song. I love that disc. And Sawyer Brown is going to be at Unforgiven on April 26th. Now, whether or not Double J can hang with them, it's another story. But Tennessee Lee, I understand, is pretty confident that Double J is going to impress everyone with his singing ability.
Mark Miller, the lead singer for Sawyer Brown, is a huge wrestling fan. And Tennessee Lee really pulled a coup to get Sawyer Brown to Unforgiven as Double J now attacks Raven Clark from behind. Talking about Unforgiven, what about The Undertaker in the Inferno match with Kane? Big elbow by Double J.
He accepted the challenge, did The Undertaker this week, and then watched via satellite as Kane and Paul Bearer desecrated his parents' graves. I mean, lighting them on fire, and you know The Undertaker just has to be beside himself. The emotion in that man's eyes alone told a huge story.
Raven Clark right out here in front of us is Double J now slams into the canvas.
Man.
So it'll be The Undertaker and Kane in an Inferno match at Unforgiven. And I also understand, Kevin, that The Undertaker will be at Raw in Philadelphia live this Monday.
And you know there's going to be a lot of emotion on the side of The Undertaker. If Kane and Paul Bearer are anywhere in the vicinity, I got a feeling fireworks are getting set to break out.
And if you're in the vicinity of the Core State Center, we understand that there may be some tickets available come Monday morning. So get out to the arena Monday morning to try to get some seats for Raw Is War.
Yeah, pretty much Raw Is War Live being sold out in any town.
Double J does the strut now, and he is in total control of Raven Clark. Double J really been on a roll as of late under Tennessee Lee. You got to give the promoter at least a little bit of credit. Here's a sunset flip. Clark into the cover now. There's two, almost an upset.
The inexperienced Raven Clark did not hook the legs, but now he's got him tied up tight.
There's two, and again, a kick out by Double J after the small package, and there's the big clothesline.
Boy, you know, everybody's talking about this Inferno match. I'm getting a lot of emails, people wanting to know what the rules are. Basically, the rules are simple. The first man that will catch on fire will be the loser of that match. The ropes will be on fire, folks. A ring surrounded by flames.
Speaking about on fire, what about the new DX? Triple H really has that group running on all cylinders.
That's right, five members strong now. The New Age Outlaws, the newest members. And I wonder what Shawn Michaels is thinking about all this as he's sitting home in San Antonio.
As I said this week on Raw, Shawn's had no comment in recent weeks about the new D-Generation X. But Shawn will make a public appearance in San Antonio at the 1998 NASCAR Raid Parade Saturday night. He's the Grand Marshal. And Double J now in trouble. Raven Clark's going to climb to the top of the ropes, and Double J's experience once again gets the better of Raven Clark.
Double J hitting Raven Clark with an Easter egg a little early there, right in the eye.
Raven Clark now. Double J with a nice suplex off the second rope. And Clark felt that one, and this should be all over. If Double J locks this in, it'll be all she wrote.
Notice how he smartly drags Raven Clark to the center of the ring, keeping him miles away from the ropes. Steve Blackman and Double J will cross paths sometime again.
Figure four leg lock. It's all over. Double J victorious.
You mean Double J is going to be singing with Sawyer Brown?
Got it. He's not just going to be singing. He's going to be performing. He's going to be the lead singer. Sawyer Brown is going to play backup for Double J.
That's S-A-W-Y-E-R. Well, you get the idea.
You got it.
Time now to visit with a handsome Doc Hendricks and Slanty.
Another guy that knows a little bit about singing.
Take it away, Doc.
Yeah, very little.
Welcome back, everybody. Was Double J looking good?
Well, think how good he will look when he is backed up by Grammy Award-winning Sawyer Brown at our next pay-per-view extravaganza, Unforgiven, in your house, Sunday, April 26th. That's just 2 weeks away. Don't forget about the evening gown matchup, Luna against Sable. The only way to win is strip your opponent down to her undergarments, Luna, Luna. Now, we have two title matches slated. New WWF champion Stone Cold Steve Austin makes his first pay-per-view title defense, and this Monday on Raw, we should find out who his opponent is. We will see the New Age Outlaws defend against LOD 2000 with the tag team titles on the line. But what about this first ever Inferno match where the ring will be surrounded in fire and the first man to catch fire is the loser? Right now, here is a very disturbed Undertaker.
Kane, you can feel any way you like about me. You can hate me all the way down to your rotten core. But you will not defile the graves of our parents. You will not make a mockery of their death and final resting place. WrestleMania was only a beginning for you. At Unforgiven, the Inferno match, I will not only light your body on fire, but I will reach in and extract your soul and throw it into an eternal damnation. You will pay for your sins, Kane. And when you're laid to rest, I'm coming for you, Paul. Because you, in fact, are the root of all that is evil. You will pay for your sins. I will show no mercy. I will extract every ounce of energy from you and throw you into the fiery pits of hell.
Tell you what, The Undertaker means business, and so do the LOD. We'll see the Leaks in the New 2000 coming up.
And not only that, but next we'll see the artist formerly known as Goldust taking on Jose from Los Pericos. Stay with us.
Few people are as tough on motor oil as cab drivers. The extreme stress and searing heat generated by their hard driving can break down an oil in no time. That's why New York's Broadway Taxi Company uses Castrol GTX, the first hard. GTX is first to meet the volatility requirements targeted for the new millennium.
Greyhound, where can we take you?
Twice the goodness,
twice the taste,
twice the smile
upon your face.
Chocolate caramel cookies times two, it's two for me and none for you.
Twix!
Have you seen what's happening on Fox 11's Good Day Wisconsin?
You're having too much fun this morning.
Look at the clown on the weather deck.
Oh, are you sleeping on the job again? Big monster truck show coming up this weekend.
I can't even explain that. They are lining up like crazy this morning.
I don't know what's wrong with her.
It's been my life's dream is to be a guy that eats donuts, overweight guy in a hardware store.
How did you know about the drive-thru cookie sale?
Actually, I saw it on your show.
Cool.
Weekdays at 5:30 on Fox 11.
I can still hear the echoes cheering my name.
Time has not silenced the crowd.
I never did a moonsault.
Or walk the top rope.
There were no pyrotechnics.
No fancy flashing lights.
We never flew through the air.
We were men of courage.
Men of steel.
They or men without fear.
I can still hear the echoes cheering my name.
But today, I cheer for them.
Oh.
Approaching the ring.
That is one of the best pieces of business we've ever done in this company.
Yeah, the last spot, not this guy.
Weighing 260 pounds, the artist, formerly known as Goulda.
I'll tell you what, I get tears every time I see that spot. I grew up watching all those guys.
And a young man here on the ropes who should have a respect for old-timers and authority, but doesn't. That's Goldust.
From Puerto Rico, weighing 225 pounds, from Los Boricuas, Jose.
Love this video.
See Jose head down to the ring now. Why don't you pay attention to the ring instead of the Titantron?
Oh, yeah. Luna's in the ring, and she's going to have her hands full at Unforgiven in the match I can't wait for, the evening gown match in just 2 weeks against Sable. And why do you take the opportunity to explain us about the rules?
Well, I don't mind. Basically, it's pretty simple. First lady to be stripped down to her skivvies won't be having her hand raised in victory. Why is it that everybody's cheering for Luna in this one to win?
Let's go, Luna!
I think what you need to focus on is the fact that Luna and Sable don't care about the embarrassing stipulations.
Let's go, Luna!
They're focusing more in on doing physical damage to one another. But you, it appears,
Let's
are just focusing
Luna.
On the stipulations.
That's right, you got it. And speaking of stipulations, there's Goldust taking on Jose Estrada. Tell you what, Sable drew first blood at WrestleMania. Luna, though, showed her expertise this past week on Raw when she beat a man. Give the assist to a Goldust.
Well, I'm not so sure Luna couldn't have done it on her own, but she certainly had Goldust soften up her victim. And I hope that Goldust stays away from ringside at Unforgiven on April 26th.
Look out, oh, big man. Body drop by Jose. Off the ropes now. Big clothesline, and Goldust is in some kind of trouble. There's a dropkick.
And I wonder how a man who's so focused on having attention drawn to himself, Goldust, feels about the spotlight being so prominently transfixed on Luna and Sable lately.
Yeah, speaking of spotlights, what about the new superstar about to debut here in the World Wrestling Federation?
Val Venus?
Val Venus. Speaking of, talk about bizarre.
What's on his resume again?
He's had a long, hard road here to the World Wrestling Federation, but Val Venus is coming. And there you see Jose Estrada now slamming Goldust into the stairs.
Well, this has been quite a battle. Jose really carrying it to Goldust so far. And speaking of battles, a lot of folks are talking about Dan Severn in the World Wrestling Federation, an old rival in Ken Shamrock, already a fixture here in the WWF. Well, folks, right now on option four, on the WWF Superstar line, Crowing with Cornette, James E. gives the whole story on a potential battle between Shamrock and Severn.
And he would know.
Will we see it happen? Call 1-900-737-4WWF. The information is on your screen. As always, appropriate charges apply.
And listen to this crowd chanting, Sable, Sable, getting all over Luna. I don't think Luna can handle it.
And I don't think we want to push this woman towards the brink of insanity any more than she already is.
She's whacked. As you see another whacked one, Goldust, working now on the left arm of Jose Estrada. Goldust, very bizarre, but in a strange state of mind as of late.
Certainly has been, and I'm telling you what, when we get to Raw this Monday from Philadelphia, the sold-out Core State Center, Stone Cold Steve Austin says he's going to settle things once and for all between he and Vince McMahon. We also know that The Undertaker will be there.
Look out, Luna may be in trouble.
Wait a minute.
And Goldust from behind.
And like I was saying, with DX in the house as well, it is going to be just an unbelievable night, folks. This Monday, live, Raw is War, 8:57, 7:57 Central on the USA Network.
I also understand we will have the first ever chain match on Raw this Monday. I cannot wait. Goldust rolls him over, hooks the leg. Here's two, and Jose kicks out.
I understand members of the Disciples of Apocalypse are going to be involved
that's
in that
right.
one. Wow, I mean, that's going to be physical. And, Michael, I don't want to let the cat out of the bag, but I've got a piece. My investigative journalistic team is working right now. I've got something very special planned this Monday on Raw, and there's going to be one WWF superstar who doesn't like it at all.
Big right uppercut that time by Jose Estrada. And Goldust now in trouble. Rake of the eyes by Goldust. Jose now really needs to try to catch a second wind. Whipped into the rope. Goldust misses with the right hand. Here's Jose. Big shoulder. A desperation move by Estrada. And now can he gain some momentum? Goldust quickly back up.
Man.
Big right hand by Estrada. There's another one. Backs Goldust into the ropes. Whipped off the ropes now. Here's Estrada. Big elbow. Wow. And the artist formerly known as Goldust is in trouble. Face first into the turnbuckle. Luna can't like what she's seeing. Goldust off the ropes. Oh, a bulldog! Nice counter that time by Goldust. And that could be all she wrote for Jose Estrada. You can hear Luna barking instructions at ringside. Here it comes. The curtain call on the way from Goldust. If he hits this, it's all over. That's it. Hooks the leg. Goldust victorious over Jose Estrada.
Here is your winner, the artist formerly known as Goldust.
How far will Luna go to get her revenge on Sable following WrestleMania? We know these two will meet at Unforgiven. You gotta figure their paths are gonna cross somewhere before April 26th. It could be this Monday, Michael, live on Raw.
Goldust victorious, folks. Plenty more still to come this week on Shotgun. The LOD 2000 with Sonny are in action next.
You think you're ready for the School of Hard Knocks? FCU is now accepting applications. You must possess strong language skills.
I will whip your and that's the bottom line.
A firm grasp of political incorrectness.
To me, it's a bunch of crap.
The ability to use sign language.
Oh, hell yeah!
Plus, have a knack for physical education. To enroll in his championship program, you need this limited edition t-shirt. To order, call 815-734-1161 or send $25 plus shipping and handling to the address on your screen. Learn from the champion, Professor Austin. Graduate from the class of 316.
There's something up there, Mulder.
Ooh, I've been saying that for years.
It's the show that's captured the imagination of America.
You really believe in this stuff, Agent Mulder?
Is that a problem?
The critically acclaimed recipient of 6 Golden Globes, 9 Emmys, and many other prestigious awards.
Approach him only with extraordinary caution and then only with adequate backup.
Currently in its 5th incredible season.
You'll pursue a case at the expense of everything to the point of insanity and expect me to follow you.
The X-Files.
I'm offering you a chance to know the truth.
In exchange for what?
Now, go behind the scenes to meet some of the people that bring you The X-Files.
It's a tremendous accomplishment. To do a TV series and to go into your 5th year, you are bucking all the odds. It's a rarity.
And proving to the world the existence of alien life is not my last dying wish.
Well, I'm as skeptical of that man as you are, but proof, definitive proof, that would change everything.
These are the kind of issues that are interesting in that they're not resolved, and so it's much better for a television show to raise questions and to raise theories.
Maybe there's a scientific explanation.
Maybe we need to keep our minds open to extreme possibility.
I think I was more daunted early on in terms of how we were going to pull something off.
There's something out there. I saw it.
Just disappeared.
What is it, Mulder?
I think if you keep making something good and you keep finding reasons to reinvent it, people are going to come back.
Kelly!
Mulder, I'm not alone.
The X-Files. If you think it can't get any better, think again. Sundays at 9, 8 Central on Fox.
WWF Unforgiven in your house. Just 2 weeks away, Sunday, April 26th is presented by 10321. Just dial it and save up to 50%. The tag team titles will be on the line April 26th. The New Age Outlaws will face this tandem. The LOD 2000 with the lovely Sonny, who's really turned this team around. And look out, here come Animal and Hawk.
Frank Stiletto, Roy Raven, why did you sign up for this one?
Animal and Hawk now. There goes Raven over the top ropes. Animal.
Oh!
My. And here we go. Doomsday device time for the LOD. Hawk to the top rope.
They're not getting paid by the minute.
The LOD sending a message. There it is. This one's over. Hawk covers Stiletto. The LOD victorious.
But she got this great team back together, clicking on all cylinders, geared towards April 26th, the tag team title match
so
at Unforgiven.
So I want to know what's this?
For Double K, I'm Michael Cole. See you next week, everybody. McMahon. Yeah, and I have one question this week, Kevin. Why, dude, why? More on that a bit later on in the program as Bradshaw now backs Harley Lewis into the corner. And there are the big knees now to the midsection of Harley Lewis.
Guys, hold up that Fire Michael Cole sign again.
Yeah, you gave it to him, didn't
no,
you?
No, I didn't. Fans are always right, though.
Nah, that's not right. Bradshaw now whipping Lewis off the rope. Big knockdown by the big Texan.
I'm telling you, Bradshaw is in just a foul mood this week, folks. He's looking for a fight. He had a hard time finding one. Harley Lewis, the only brave man perhaps in the locker room.
I'll tell you where you're going to find plenty of fights. Next weekend, WWF Unforgiven in your house. More on that in the broadcast. And what chops by Bradshaw. I have never seen Bradshaw in this type of mood, the intensity he's had over the past few weeks.
He's also talked about his lariat maneuver.
Oh, what a clothesline.
Following
wow.
Harley Lewis in. And, folks, I think this one's going to be over in very short order, but he no longer wants his lariat called a lariat. It's a lariat. Anybody can throw a lariat, but he throws the clothesline from hell, and we might see it
wow.
in just a little bit.
A gut-wrench powerbomb by Bradshaw. Off the ropes now. Harley Lewis in trouble, and there's the big elbow into the sternum.
Kind of a vacuous look in the eyes of Harley Lewis before this match started. That condition hasn't improved with Bradshaw womping on him here.
And Bradshaw wants to end this thing quickly. Great reaction from the crowd here.
What a huge crowd we've got. A huge crowd everywhere. The WWF is live, and we know there's going to be a gigantic crowd at the Greensboro Coliseum next Sunday night for WWF Unforgiven.
It's going to be great, of course. We know Stone Cold Steve Austin will face Dude Love for the championship. More on that a bit later on.
Yeah, Dude Love, the number one contender.
Yeah, I got a story about that one a bit later on in the show. There's a big boot by Bradshaw. I had the opportunity to catch up with Dude Love this week. I'll tell you all about that. We'll also talk about this upcoming Inferno match between The Undertaker and Kane. And that story is getting really bizarre. And there's a big shot by Bradshaw.
Plus, there's a six-man tag team match to announce, in case you missed that one, folks, involving members of the Nation of Domination and their former leader, as well as a stipulation added to the European title match between Owen Hart and Triple H. You won't believe it.
Yeah, China's going to be hanging around in that one. And here's Bradshaw now, setting up Harley Lewis with a pump handle slam. Wow!
Not much left to Harley Lewis, and could it be time for the clothesline from hell that Bradshaw's been talking so much about?
Yeah, Bradshaw could have ended this thing about 2 minutes ago. Referee Jimmy Cordero's looking on. Here he comes now. Oh, the clothesline from hell, and that's it. Bradshaw going to simply cover Lewis, and it is all over.
Says he got the name from hearing it from so many of his opponents.
Here is opener.
They say, what happened to you when you faced Bradshaw? And all they can do is hold their neck and say, man, the clothesline from hell.
Bradshaw on a roll, getting the support from the capacity crowd here this week on Shotgun, and he still sure has his sights set on Cornette and Windham.
I got three words for Doc Hendricks. Hey, Doc, you the man.
All right, thanks, guys. Hello, everybody. Welcome to WWF Slam Jam. It is Handsome Doc Hendricks, and we are 1 week away from the next WWF pay-per-view extravaganza, Unforgiven, in your house. Next Sunday, April 26th, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 o'clock Pacific, totally L-I-V-E live. What a time it's going to be. New WWF champion, Stone Cold Steve Austin, makes his first pay-per-view title defense, and now we know who his opponent will be. his former tag team partner, Dude Love. And how did Dude Love become the number one contender here in the World Wrestling Federation? In addition to that, we know that D-Generation X will be very busy next week at Unforgiven in Your House. The New Age Outlaws defend the tag team titles against LOD 2000. And Triple H defends the European title against Owen Hart. And China will be suspended above the ring in a cage. Right now, let's hear from D-Generation X.
You know, X-Pac, I was just wondering with Owen, right? After he puts China in a cage, and I still beat him anyways, you think he's going to go down there?
Down where?
Right down there.
Well, D-2000, we beat you like little kids before. We can do it again, I assure you. Tell him, dog.
Dinosaurs don't wear gold. Champions do.
Hey, two words. Suck it.
Well, now, don't let DX's adolescent attitude fool you. They will have a plan for next Sunday at Unforgiven in Your House, one way or the other. And one way or the other, somebody will be on fire. In the first ever Inferno match, brother versus brother, The Undertaker against Kane, the ring will be surrounded in fire, and the first man to catch fire loses. In addition to that, you will also see the first ever evening gown matchup between Luna and Sable. I love it. The only way to win is to strip your opponent down to her undergarments. All this and so much more next Sunday, April 26th.
Still to come on Shotgun, The Rock leads his team into a six-man tag team matchup.
Plus, the whole world's talking about it. Stone Cold gets the taste slapped out of his mouth.
Nestle Crunch. It's just more fun to munch.
Yoo-hoo! Our mail got mixed up again. Your phone bill sure is low.
Thanks. Dialing 10321 is saving me a ton.
And look at all those long talks with your brother.
Save 50% off every call over 20 minutes.
You should have told me 10321 saves so much.
It's no secret that perspiration and stress can lead to breakouts.
Sorry.
But right now, that's the last thing on Sarah's mind. She uses Triple Action Stridex to deal with zits. Stridex fights zits three ways, so Sarah can worry about more important things. Stridex. Deal with it.
So, trying to squeeze 6 months of physics into an all-night cramathon? This will get your protons moving. Just when you're losing that kinetic energy, bang! Dodgeball to the mouth. You got that, Einstein?
Starburst Fruit Juice.
It's Einstein.
If love is your question, Psychic Talk has your answer.
Are you seeing two women right now?
Oh, man.
Well, you think that they won't know they're psychics.
Carrying on these two relationships, you are looking at fatherhood.
Is someone pregnant now?
No way you could get that right on the money like that.
About your husband, he's a very dominating man, isn't he?
Yes. He likes to keep you subservient because he's afraid of losing you. Right. I am very impressed to hear the ladies be right on target. Really amazes me.
I just wanted to see if he has been unfaithful to me.
You already know. You've already had the evidence there. Yes, he is.
Wow, you guys are good.
Is there a baby in his life? Because I just pick up that he begged her to have this baby.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah. Huh.
Everything that they're saying to you right now is
Everything is true.
Wow.
This is incredible. I can't believe it.
Everyone who calls will get a free psychic reading with our gifted psychics. It's free, so call now.
Call 1-800-516-7279.
Welcome back to Shotgun, everybody. I'm Michael Cole, my colleague Kevin Kelly in the ring, with an opportunity to interview that man, the Jackal, with the giant Kurgan at his side. We've talked a lot about this man and what he preaches. We're going to hear from him right now. Well, Jackal, you requested this interview time, so the floor is yours.
Just as the prophet who came before me descended amongst the lepers and licked their wounds clean, so today do I walk into the miasmatic scum that are all of you. the soiled masses, you the wretched refuse of society. But you know, the stench that emanates from this audience tonight can be matched only by the stench that reaches all the way to the top of Titan Towers. And the stench is the stench of conspiracy unmatched in human history. You know, Kevin Kelly, you can relate with having your career held back, I'm sure. Because you see, I'm sick of the fact that I am the greatest communicator in the World Wrestling Federation. But despite that obvious fact, I am constantly censored. I am constantly kept off live television. And the corporate juggernaut that is the World Wrestling Federation has dismantled my floating pulpit. And I have been banned from World Wrestling Federation house shows. Despite the fact, to use your vernacular, Kevin, despite the fact that I am over like nobody's business.
What is he talking about?
We all know that there are people here in the World Wrestling Federation with limited intellects and limited ability who have jobs here today because of me, who have food in their children's stomachs because of me. We all know, Kevin, that a scant 6 months ago, this man was a corporate sideshow attraction. And now, under my tutelage, he stands before you, a 7 foot, eating, sleeping, breathing, walking, talking, pituitary gland, pumping growth hormone all over the floor, and the most feared man in the World Wrestling Federation. So I come out amongst you today to deliver a message. And my message is this. I have put in the World Wrestling Federation and Vince McMahon on notice that I will take over the WWF. The revolution of the jackal is coming, and I am aware that all of you are not intellectually able to engage in intellectual intercourse with me. So I suggest that each and every one of you sit back, listen to every word I say, and jackal off.
What? Come on. I guess you can... I'm with you, Kevin. My sentiments exactly, but I guess he can say whatever he wants to say when he's got that 7 foot monster Kurgan standing next to him. The Jackal preaching his book here on Shotgun this week. Folks, plenty more still to come. What a show we got ahead. The Intercontinental Champ, The Rock, the ruler of the nation, will be in action in a six-man tag team matchup. Plus, we'll show you the love triangle with Stone Cold, Dude Love, and Vince McMahon. But up next, the newly formed tag team, Too Much, Taylor and Christopher, on the way. He's the toughest SOB in the WWF.
Oh, hell yeah!
He's Vince McMahon's worst nightmare.
Give me a hell yeah!
He's the World Wrestling Federation champion.
Oh, hell yeah!
Now, are you ready to raise some hell? Do it with the Stone Cold Steve Austin Hell Yeah T-shirt. To order the limited edition Hell Yeah T-shirt, call 815-734-1161 or send $25 plus shipping and handling to the address on your screen. Go ahead and raise some hell with Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Fall in. One, two, three,
this is for my grandmother, who showed me what real courage is, and for myself, who found it.
So, trying to squeeze 6 months of physics into an all-night cramathon? This'll get your protons moving. Just when you're losing that kinetic energy, bang! Dodgeball to the mouth. You got that, Einstein?
Starburst fruit juice.
It's Einstein.
It's a scorching 98.6 degrees inside your mouth.
Yeah!
But inside a winter fresh mouth?
Tastes much, much cooler.
Winter Fresh gum from Wrigley's.
I see cool flavor. I see cool breath.
It's gonna last and last and last. Try Winter Fresh gum from Wrigley's. For icy cool breath that lasts.
Do you
people are as tough on motor oil as cab drivers. The extreme stress and searing heat generated by their hard driving can break down an oil in no time. That's why New York's Broadway Taxi Company uses Castrol GTX, the first leading 10W30 to meet the tougher volatility requirements targeted for the new millennium. Because some people don't have time to worry about motor oil. Castrol GTX, drive hard. GTX is first to meet the volatility requirements targeted for the new millennium.
Hi there.
Hello.
Now, you want to be shocked and amazed by our psychics, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Well, this time, it's me who's going to shock and amaze you.
Oh, really?
Yes, really. I'm giving you 12 full minutes with a real psychic for free.
12 full minutes? All in one call?
Yes, all in one call. No strings attached. This 12 free minutes is for real.
Then do I have to join a club or something?
No. This free is better than free. In fact, you're under no obligation to spend a single dime, and you will definitely get your 12 minutes free.
Well, it sounds pretty good.
Honey, listen to me. This is so free that you speak directly to your psychic on an 800 number.
On an 800 number? Wow, it really is free.
Exactly. So don't miss out. Pick up your phone and call this number right now. Get your free psychic reading with 12 full minutes free.
Call now for the best long-distance rates and get 12 minutes free. Speak to your psychic directly through an 800 number. This psychic reading really is free.
Call 1-800-860-9849.
Hey, everybody, we're back on Shotgun. I'll tell you what, I'm looking forward to this tag team matchup. Brand new team debuting this week.
The bubbling tag team contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Approaching the ring at a total combined weight of 421 pounds, the team of Too Sexy.
Kevin, what do you think about it? Too much? Well, I'd like to see them perform together before I make any judgments, but their individual resumes are very impressive. And it's a pressure cooker of competition within the light heavyweight division. I'm surprised Scott Taylor is teaming with Brian Christopher, but you know, sometimes great enemies sometimes make your best friends.
Yeah, but have you noticed in recent weeks a change in the demeanor of Scott Taylor?
They become a lot more confident. And while it's cocky, brash, yes. I think some would say, and not the way he was when he first came into the World Wrestling Federation, but certainly much more in line with the style of Brian Christopher. And they're going to have their hands full this week with two veterans here, Devin Storm and Ace Darling. Should be an interesting tag team matchup, light heavyweights all. And the crowd now getting on Brian Christopher. Folks, don't forget, next Sunday night, Greensboro, North Carolina, it is Unforgiven in your house. The tag title's on the line. The New Age Outlaws to meet LOD 2000. That is going to be an interesting matchup.
New elements involved in both sides there. You've got the New Age Outlaws, the newest members of D-Generation X, and LOD 2000 reborn, just about reformed thanks to their new manager, Sonny. It's going to be a very interesting contest, but an old score. The LOD has wanted the New Age Outlaws for a long time. It could happen next Sunday at Unforgiven.
The New Age Outlaws taking the belts away from the Legion of Doom back in late 1997. As Ace Darling now locks up with Scott Taylor. Nice arm drag takedown by Scott Too Hot Taylor.
Yeah, Too Hot. Where did that name come from?
I have no idea. I thought they were talking about you.
Well, he's thrown in, I think, with the wrong crowd here with Christopher. They could be surprised, though, because Ace Darling and Devin Storm, they are a very well-recognized team. They have a lot of popularity. They do incredible high-flying maneuvers, and it could be too much to handle, I guess, for Too Much.
Snapmare by Scott Taylor, and he's applauding himself, and now gets a little high, a 10 that time by Too Sexy Brian Christopher. And listen to the response from the crowd here. Not huge fans, obviously, of the alleged son of Jerry the King Lawler. And Taylor now locks up again with Ace Darling. Side headlock by Darling now. Off the ropes goes Darling, whipped in by Scott Taylor. Nice takedown that time with a shoulder. Darling over the top. Taylor, wow, what a move by Scott Taylor.
Great tilt-a-whirl slam. Taylor with a lot of strength for just a man at 212 pounds.
Misses with the elbow, though, and Ace Darling quickly back up. Nice takedown into a pinning combination. There's two. Pete Taylor just kicks out, almost had him.
Boy, there's some of that agility we talked about. And Darling follows up with the clothesline.
Another cover. Quick again. There's two, and Taylor again pops out.
We'll see if Darling and Storm are able to get some tag team continuity together. I wonder if Taylor and Christopher have been working out, getting some combination moves put together.
Oh, double back body drop. Taylor felt that one, and he's heading for higher ground. Some cover for Too Sexy. What is this?
Well, Christopher not paying attention to the ring or his partner, surprised that he's there.
And here's the tag now, and Too Sexy into the ring. Got to concentrate on Devin Storm as opposed to this crowd. One of the knocks on Brian Christopher, obviously very, very talented. But he a little too cocky in the ring.
Sometimes a lack of focus could be a downfall there for Brian Christopher.
Side headlock by Devin Storm. Off the ropes. Too Sexy knocks him off. Over the top comes Devin Storm. Leapfrog by Brian Christopher. Turnaround drop kick. Nice move. And he struts around the ring like a chicken. Like a rooster in heat.
Like a mullet.
Yeah, that's good. And Devin Storm now huddling with Ace Darling. Folks, Unforgiven just a week away. Greensboro, North Carolina next Sunday night. Everyone is talking about the Inferno match.
First time ever in the World Wrestling Federation. Kane against The Undertaker. But we know that this Monday on Raw, Michael, Paul Bearer issued the challenge for Kane and The Undertaker to meet at the cemetery where their parents were laid to rest in the tomb and headstones were desecrated just a couple of weeks ago.
Christopher leapfrog over Devin Storm. Going to do it one more time. Here we go. Misses with a drop kick. Smart move by Devin Storm. Now on the apron of the ring. Storm likes to fly. There we go. Right across the sternum. Quick as a cat. Here comes Ace Darling.
Off the slingshot leg. Wow. Now double drop kick. Brian Christopher rolling out of the ring. Here comes Scott Taylor.
And Taylor goes down as well. And Darling now and Devin Storm on a roll.
Not exactly an auspicious debut for the team of Too Much, kind of consoling themselves outside.
Look out!
Oh!
Wow! Yeah! And Darling loved it, and he asked you, pat yourself on the back. That was a tremendous double team.
I tell you, Darling and Storm have competed together and against each other in the Northeast for several years now, really showing some continuity.
And Scott Taylor tossed back into the ring by his own
partner. What about that?
Too Sexy didn't want to go in. And now Taylor.
Oh, wait a minute. Brian Christopher, this is a plot, Michael.
From behind, Too Sexy. Oh, noggin knocker, look out. And Scott Taylor applauding his new partner.
Almost like an audible. Brian Christopher kind of called that play on the fly, and it was very effective.
There's a big boot to the head. Who's the leader of this team, Too Much, do you figure?
I guarantee it's Brian Christopher.
Does he think he's the leader, or do you really think he is the leader?
He's the man who put the I in team.
And here comes Brian Christopher now, back into the ring. Double team by Too Much. Wow! Devin Storm feels that one. Taylor off the ropes, drop kick into the face.
Boy, that's some smart teamwork right there.
Folks, we're talking about Unforgiven next week. The European title will be on the line, the rematch. It's Triple H against Owen Hart.
What a big announcement you had on Livewire.
Unreal. China is going to be in a 7-foot-tall, 3-foot-wide steel cage suspended above the ring so she can't get involved.
Well, Commissioner Slaughter obviously reacting to trying to do his best to control China. He thought he had it under the situation under control at WrestleMania. Obviously, that wasn't enough. So Commissioner Slaughter now taking even more drastic steps.
Christopher biting the hand of Devin Storm.
Looks to me like, though, Michael, that Owen Hart is finally going to get a fair shot, a fair shake at getting back his European title.
Brian Christopher now going to work on Devin Storm. Referee Jack Doan checking Storm. There's Scott Taylor on the apron of the ring for this team. Too Much. But again, Unforgiven in your house just a week away.
Folks, in a little while, we're going to show you what went down between Stone Cold Steve Austin and Vince McMahon.
That's coming up next.
Oh, man, the slap heard around the world and so much more.
Devin Storm off the ropes. Christopher misses with the right hand. Misses again. Here's Storm now. Slides underneath. Christopher turns around. Devin misses with the right hand. Look out, full Nelson. Oh, my! Face first into the mat.
Well, he planted him.
Christopher using that move to his advantage week in and week out.
Now, instead of going for the cover or tagging in Taylor, Christopher going and jawing with the crowd.
Inexperience, perhaps, on the part of Brian Christopher.
Well, he's very experienced. Young man, I mean, he's 25 years old, 8 years as a pro, around it his entire life. He knows better. It's a lack of focus.
Would you still consider Brian Christopher the top contender for the light heavyweight title?
Absolutely, and I'd put Taylor a close second. He took Taka Michinoku to the limit last week right here on Shotgun.
What a suplex on Devin Storm by Brian Christopher. And what about the situation Taka has as Christopher now goes for the cover? There's two, and Devin Storm kicks out. Taka has to watch his back every time he wrestles a match now because of Club Kamikaze.
I'm telling you, they're coming from all directions. Taka doesn't know whether they're coming or going, and it's really starting to bother the young man.
Here's the double team now. Scott Taylor hammering away at the head of Devin Storm. Whipped into the corner with authority by Brian Christopher. And now Scott Taylor setting him up for a classic double team. Christopher. Oh, no, reversal. Oh, Taylor hit his own partner.
And Storm now needs to make the tag.
From behind, and Taylor and Christopher go down.
Storm deciding to stay in rather than tag in Ace Darling. Wait a minute.
And here comes Ace Darling now. Big right hand to Christopher. Right hand to Scott Taylor. Another right hand. Kick to the midsection. Taylor whipped off the ropes now. Hurricane Rana. Darling's going to try it again, and he gets it with Christopher. I'll tell you what, too much in all kinds of trouble. Wow.
All four men are in. Storm and Darling taking the fight to too much.
Here we go now. Look out. Oh, big clotheslines. Taylor and Christopher now regaining the momentum.
This match has been a battle.
It really has. Too much of an impressive. There goes Devin Storm. And Ace Darling now left to the Sharks in the ring. Taylor. Body slam.
Now looking to isolate. They've got their opening.
And Christopher's going to climb the ropes. He's going to go perhaps for the Tennessee Jam. Wow, pump handle suplex by Taylor. Christopher now off the top ropes. He's going to fly. Tennessee Jam, it's over. Darling will not get up. Here's the cover. Too much. Victorious.
Here are your winners. The team of two sexy Brian Christopher and Scott Taylor.
Faces only moms could love.
Wow. Too hot. Too sexy. They definitely are too much. We'll see what this light heavyweight team can do here in the World Wrestling Federation. They're going to kiss.
Oh, man. And Christopher, look at the smile on his face. Folks, plenty more to come on Shotgun. You'll see The Rock, the self-proclaimed Intercontinental Champ, teaming with the Nation for a six-man tag match.
And up next, the WWF Champion Stone Cold Steve Austin and Vince McMahon square off inside the squared circle when we return.
Hey, you look stoked.
Yeah, I just snagged a surfer.
A surfer? So what's the big deal?
He was chewing Cineburst.
Flavor crystals? Flavor crystals? Excellent! Yes!
Cineburst with flavor crystals. Bite the burst.
Greyhound can take you just about anywhere in America. And when you plan ahead, you can get there for $59 or less. Fare so low, you're free to go. Greyhound, where can we take you?
Twice the goodness,
twice the taste,
twice the smile
upon your face.
Chocolate caramel cookies times two,
it's two for me and none for you.
What's the latest fashion? Stylish casual and active apparel from your home team, Fox 11. Step out in style in t-shirts, sweatshirts, sportswear, and outerwear in a wide range of popular styles and colors, accented with this sporty embroidered Fox 11 logo. To see all the hot new Fox 11 fashions and to order yours, hit our website at www.wluk.com. Stop by Fox 11 or drop us a line and we'll send you a brochure. Sport the colors of your favorite station with casual apparel from your home team, Fox 11.
It's Fox Comedy Monday. First, will Damon's romantic evening backfire?
Whatever you do, don't.
An all-new Damon. Then, what's worse than seeing your mom with your old boyfriend? Hearing them.
Boom! What's my name?
It's a getting personal you can't miss. Plus, can Ellie save her boss from being sued?
If I could just get Barbara Walters to ask the questions. Do you have regrets?
Ellie McBeal. It all starts at 8, 7 Central, Fox Comedy Monday.
So, trying to squeeze 6 months of physics into an all-night cramathon? This will get your protons moving. Just when you're losing that kinetic energy, bang! Dodgeball to the mouth. You got that, Einstein?
Starburst Fruit Juice.
This Einstein.
Greyhound can take you just about anywhere in America. And when you plan ahead, two can travel for the price of one with the Greyhound Companion Fare. Fare so low, you're free to go. Greyhound. Where can we take you?
Few people are as tough on motor oil as cab drivers. The extreme stress and searing heat generated by their hard driving can break down an oil in no time. That's why New York's Broadway Taxi Company uses Castrol GTX, the first leading 10W30 to meet the tougher volatility requirements targeted for the new millennium. Because some people don't have time to worry about motor oil. Castrol GTX, drive hard. GTX is first to meet the volatility requirements targeted for the new millennium.
Hi, I'm Tom Milburn. How can you help give students the marketable skills they need for future success? By investing your time and money in the Junior Achievement Program.
The ultimate objective is to have a higher skilled workforce.
It's something that we can give back to the community, and this is something that you should invest in.
I really like Junior Achievement. It's very beneficial.
Junior Achievement. It's more than a giving decision. It's a good business decision. For more information, call 494-5299.
If someone told you about steps that can help keep you safe, you would listen, wouldn't you? Listening and taking steps is what the Take Back the Night rally and march is all about. I'm urging you to join us on Friday evening, April 24th at the Brown County Courthouse.
And we'll be joined by author Eileen Ross, a rape survivor who now spends her time teaching others how to be safe.
Don't miss Terry Barr Keeps You Safe stories every weeknight on Fox 11 News.
We're back on Shotgun. Listen to this. Wow.
The following six-man tag team match is scheduled for one fall in a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, accompanied by fellow Nation of Domination member Kama Mustafa, and a total combined weight of 912 pounds, D'Lo Brown, the world's strongest man, Mark Henry, and the World Wrestling Federation's Intercontinental Champion, The Rock.
They have a new ruler, and obviously a new attitude. Brand new entrance music, I understand, custom ordered by The Rock.
And Brian Baker.
Only the best for the Intercontinental Champions, so says The Rock.
Six-man tag team matchup,
look
The Rock, D'Lo, and Mark Henry to take on Al Phillips, Mark Schrader, and Brian Knighton. And folks, we have a six-man tag team matchup set for Unforgiven. It's going to be Shamrock, Blackman, and Farouk against The Rock, Mark Henry, and D'Lo Brown.
Well, this past week on Raw, Farouk was calling out The Rock. And The Rock answered with The Nation. But Farouk had a surprise for his former nation in the form of Ken Shamrock and the lethal weapon Steve Blackman. And very quickly, The Rock and The Nation found themselves in a fight. What a war, folks, this is going to be. These six men will collide at Unforgiven next Sunday. The Rock and Farouk. And look at the shirt that The Rock had on. That's a heat getter.
Yeah, what's that all about? As D'Lo Brown now gets set to lock up with Al Phillips. What the heck are Phillips, Knighton, and Schrader thinking about signing this match?
Well, you know, when you're a young competitor in the World Wrestling Federation, sometimes you have to sign for matches that might not be in your career's best interest, but that's the way you learn.
D'Lo misses with the right hand. There's Al Phillips now hammering her way at the side of a D'Lo Brown. D'Lo again misses with the right hand. Phillips very quick. Look out. Wow. Powerbomb.
A lot of experts are calling this the breakout year for D'Lo Brown. Certainly 1997 was for The Rock, and Mark Henry's future very bright. Don't forget about Kama down there in the corner. He's sporting that new lid.
D'Lo Brown now firmly in control, and Kevin, I still can't get over what we saw this past week on Raw. That whole situation between Dude and Stone Cold and Vince McMahon. Now we know Dude Love is going to be meeting Stone Cold Steve Austin and Unforgiven. All of a sudden, the Dude is the number one contender.
And that seemed to just magically happen. And now Mark Henry is in pounding away on Al Phillips. Mark Henry called the strength coordinator of the nation.
Yeah, the world's strongest man. He goes 400 pounds, and he's getting direction now from The Rock. Phillips quickly out of the way, and now he tags in Mark Schrader. Schrader off the ropes. Look at this.
Oh,
look at Mark
Henry.
Pressing Schrader. Oh, my.
Woo. Extending the arms and sending Schrader into the lights.
Now, Kevin, I understand some big backstage news after Raw this past week involving Dude, Vince, and Stone Cold.
And right now, folks, you can hear about it on the WWF Superstar Line. Option 4, the Ross Report.
Find out what happened behind the scenes between the WWF champion Stone Cold Steve Austin, Mr. McMahon, and Dude Love. JR has the scoop. Option 4, 1-900-737-4WWF.
And here's the Intercontinental Champion, The Rock, who's going to have to deal with two issues at Unforgiven in that six-man tag match. He's going to have to deal with Farooq and Ken Shamrock. A little unfinished business there.
And everyone in this crowd and in the huge crowd that's expected in Greensboro wants to see Farooq tear the head off of The Rock.
Rock whipping Schrader into the corner now. Look at this. Up top. Wow!
All the way slam, beautifully executed.
Schrader felt that one.
It's a real air of confidence within the Nation of Domination right now. Never stronger.
Slam by The Rock. And we've seen this before. Looks like he's going to set him up here, Kevin, for the people's elbow. Off the ropes. A little fake that time by The Rock. Uncalled for. The Rock could have pinned this guy 5 minutes ago.
Oh, the Nation is clicking on all cylinders.
And The Rock telling his teammates, tag in.
Brian Knight now coming to smell what The Rock's cooking.
And The Rock hammering away now at Knight into the corner. D'Lo wants some, and here comes D'Lo Brown. The Nation of Domination. Since The Rock took over, been on an incredible roll.
This Monday is going to be a Long Island street fight, though. Farooq has challenged any member of the Nation of Domination to a Long Island street fight from Uniondale's Nassau Coliseum. That'll happen this Monday on Raw Is War.
Come as you are, bring what you want. Over top now.
Here we go.
He's got D'Lo. We can have an upset here. Only one kick out by D'Lo Brown. Follows it up with a big clothesline. He almost decapitated Knight.
Boy, Knight not only got hit in the front, his head hit that canvas very hard.
D'Lo now setting Knight up. Backbreaker across the knee. And D'Lo now is going to climb. And if he hits this here, this is the lowdown, folks. This is beautifully executed by a 300-pounder. Look at that!
Oh, man. You know, if you're a buck 85 doing a frog splash, that's one thing. But when you're D'Lo Brown and you deliver the lowdown, there is nobody, and I mean nobody, that does it like that.
And here comes Mark Henry. The world's strongest man delivering perhaps the world's strongest elbow right into the sternum of Knight. And now The Rock wants some.
Oh, man, out of the frying pan, into another frying pan, and now into the fire.
And The Rock now into the ring. Brian Knight is in la-la land. The Rock now setting him up for the rock bottom. There it is! Oh, my! And I think Mr. Knighton is nighty-night. And it is over. The Nation victorious, but I don't think it's going to be that easy at Unforgiven.
Well, it certainly isn't. Farooq is going to be leading Shamrock and Blackman in this battle against The Rock. And look at The Rock standing in the corner while having the rest of the Nation stomp away.
Know your role.
This was a very, very impressive, devastating performance by a new and improved Nation of Domination.
Let's go to Slam Jam. Here's Doc.
Welcome back to WWF Slam Jam. We just saw the Nation of Domination in action and dominating. Will they be able to dominate next Sunday, April 26th at Unforgiven in your house? We will find out. It will be The Rock, D'Lo Brown, and Mark Henry taking on the lethal weapon, Steve Blackman, the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, and get this, the former leader of the Nation of Domination, none other than Farooq. And right now, standing by is Farooq.
Unforgiven. That couldn't be a more appropriate title for the way I feel. You know what, D'Lo, Rocky, and Mark Henry, here are three people that I literally raised and gave them the position where they are now in the World Wrestling Federation. But guess what? The old saying is like your father and your mother told you, I brought you in this world and I'll take you out. And Unforgiven, I brought you into the Nation. And guess what? Farooq and Ken Shamrock and Lethal Weapon will take you out.
Whoa, something's going to happen next Sunday. I mean, keep in mind, Farooq, the former leader of the Nation of Domination, handpicked every member. So that means he knows their strengths and their weaknesses. And what a time it's going to be at Unforgiven in your house. Double J Jeff Jarrett with the greatest promoter in the world, Tennessee Lee, will be performing with country great Sawyer Brown. And I'll tell you what's really going to be great is that evening gown match between Luna and Sable. The only way to win is strip. your opponent's clothes all the way off till she's down to her undergarments. I'm getting a ringside seat. Tell you what else I want to see. LOD 2000 challenging the New Age Outlaws for the tag team titles. Owen Hart challenging Triple H for the European title. And China way above the ring inside of a cage. And I'm very curious to see what happens in the WWF Championship match. Stone Cold defending the title against Dude Love. And let us not forget the first ever Inferno match, The Undertaker against Kane. All this and so much more next Sunday, April 26th, Unforgiven in your house.
Up next on Shotgun, tag team action with the Headbangers taking on the Quebecers. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
And now, get your protons moving with the Starburst Fruit Juice Slam of the Week. Give it some juice.
Too cold, moved out of the way.
Too cold, was too smart.
And Terry Butt now in the ring.
What's this?
Too cold.
Oh,
got him.
A 450 splash brought them to their feet.
Door.
Too cold, Scorpio. What a way to launch his new career here in the WWF.
Give it some juice with the Starburst Fruit Juice Slam of the Week. Got that, Einstein?
It's Einstein.
Flowers, flowers, pretty little flowers.
Hello, would you like a flower? Can I have one? If you have two of something, you should share one. If you have two, share one, share one, share one.
Two for me.
None for you.
Bobby?
What do you want?
We've got to talk. These kids you're mixed up with don't know right from wrong.
They're my friends.
People who don't dial 1-800-COLLECTOR are nobody's friends. 1-800-COLLECTOR is 10 cents a minute every evening.
Really?
This isn't a game, kid. You could be saving your parents money.
Bobby, with us or him?
You made the right choice, son.
1-800-COLLECT, 10 cents a minute every evening.
Suzanne dreamed of being famous.
She's going to be the next Barbara Walters.
But how could someone who looks so good be so bad?
Did you get the gun?
The critically acclaimed movie of a woman with stars in her eyes and murder on her mind.
Did you get those kids to kill your husband?
Nicole Kidman, Matt Dillon, the network premiere To Die For, Tuesday at 8, 7 Central.
If you see breaking news, call Fox 11 at 1-800-236-TIPS. Or from your Cellular One phone, press star TV 11.
The ultimate Packers souvenir could be yours. This beautiful Super Bowl 31 bell will be raffled off on June 13th at the Brown County Fairgrounds. The bell is a one-of-a-kind masterpiece from the Richland Center Foundry in Richland, Wisconsin. Proceeds benefit the Military Road Sesquicentennial Wagon Train. Show your Packer pride and help preserve Wisconsin history. Tickets are available from the Green Bay Hall of Fame and these area businesses. From your home team, WLUK, Fox 11.
WWF Unforgiven in your house is proudly presented by 10321. Next Sunday, live, April 26th, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. Just dial it and save up to 50%.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one call with a 20-minute time limit. Approaching the ring from the front of the ring, and a total combined weight of 127 pounds, shot in the air, the Quebecer.
Toronto is a beautiful city. Montreal is a great city. Molson's a great beer, but I could do without Quebec.
Me too.
Not a great Canadian export.
Former WWF Tag Team Champions Howard, get out of the way.
Is that Peach he's wearing? That is Peach.
So the Headbangers ready for action this week here on Shotgun. And they were the recipient of some bad news from The Undertaker.
Well, they certainly were. An unfortunate treatment from the Headbangers. Nobody deserved to be treated that way by The Undertaker. I know The Undertaker is upset, but hey, come on. You know there are limits. And the Headbangers are upset about it. They're not going to forget about it. I got a feeling they're going to take it out here, look to anyway, against Jacques and Pierre.
And what about this Monday on Raw? Some sort of confrontation planned at the gravesite to The Undertaker and Kane's parents.
Yeah, Paul Bearer continues to pick at this sore and won't let it heal. And We know that just a week from now, in the Inferno match, the first time ever in the World Wrestling Federation, Kane and The Undertaker will meet in a ring surrounded by fire.
A little bit of slam dancing by the Headbangers, and here we go! Look out! Laurel and Hardy routine by the Quebecers.
Yeah, not quite the Canadian two-step there.
Off the ropes goes Willette. Big back body drop by the Headbangers. There's Jacques now, whipped off the ropes. Oh, to the midsection. Double team by the Headbangers.
Headbangers now setting up. Watch out!
Oh!
Oh, man.
They are a well-oiled machine. I know we use that term a lot, but it's true when you talk about these two kids.
They certainly are, and they are one of the most popular teams ever in the World Wrestling Federation, and they're really putting it together here against the Quebecers.
Well, head off the ropes, caught by a big clothesline by Thrasher. Here's a quick cover now.
Early end of this one.
Saved by Jacques.
Didn't hook the leg either. They can't afford to make mistakes to this veteran duo, Masha Thrasher, and now Thrasher sent all the way to the floor right out in front of us.
What is Willette going to do here?
Oh, wow!
That is 285 pounds over the top ropes. Wow. Yeah, Jacques Rougeau
verbally berating the crowd. Sent back in. Here we go.
Covered now by Jacques, saved by Mosh. And now Rougeau chasing Mosh back to the corner. Mosh hammering away.
Referee Tim White having a hard time controlling these four.
Thrasher from behind. And there's Pierre. Both of these teams have held the WWF Tag Team titles. We're expecting a great matchup. We've got one so far. Mosh slamming Jacques. And here we go now.
What is this?
Double team by the Headbangers. Oh, my! Cover. There's two. And now Pierre makes the save.
Neither team allowed to get any momentum. Neither team having a real opportunity to isolate their opponent on their side of the ring.
Pierre from behind, and now Jacques Rougeau looks to take advantage.
Certainly this Monday, folks, Raw is War is going to be electrifying from the Nassau Coliseum. Who knows what's going to happen? Stone Cold Steve Austin, the Vince McMahon situation, that's not going to end. Dude Love, the number one contender. Yeah, and Austin's challenger at Unforgiven. And I understand you had a conversation with Dude Love.
Yeah, Dude Love told me, asked him, how are you the number one contender? He said it was simple. He was injured a few months back when he was thrown off the stage by the New Age Outlaws,
right?
Broke some ribs, so we haven't seen Dude Love basically since December. He says he was the number one contender when he left. Now that he comes back, he's the number one contender again. Why? When Monica Seles got stabbed, she was the number one contender in tennis. She came back, she was still number one. So that's his analogy.
You ever heard of apples and oranges there, dude?
Whatever.
Well, anyway.
And here's Pierre now, in control.
Well, I know Austin is hot.
He's real hot.
Hotter than a firecracker, folks. And he's not going to let this situation die. I mean, Vince McMahon, a lot of people say, would have made a tragic mistake if he would have locked up with Austin this past Monday on Raw. And who knows what's going to happen this week.
Thrasher desperately wanting a tag from Mosh. And now Jacques Rougeau comes over and tags Thrasher himself. And now everybody in the ring. But referee Tim White sending Thrasher back to the corner. And the Quebecers taking... Off the ropes goes Mosh. Here's the double team by the Quebecers. Kick to the midsection. Oh, wow.
Watch this.
What a double team. The Headbangers in trouble.
Here's the cover
now by Jacques Rougeau. Saved by Thrasher. Folks, we got to take a break. We'll be right back.
Next, Jenny Jones. It's sheer madness.
If she don't want to be teased, then do something with your hair.
But their hair isn't their worst problem.
He teased me so bad that I changed school.
It's her fault that she's taking it so seriously.
Why is that funny to you, to hurt someone's feelings?
There used to be a kid that teased me when I was in school. He actually had a crush on me.
Now, Jenny gets to the root of the problem.
Doesn't she look good?
And sets things straight. Next, Jenny Jones.
Jenny Jones, weekdays at noon.
Montel presents a story of raw emotion.
What are you going to do, Brooke?
I'm going to prove to them that I am a good mother. I do care.
Brooke's mother couldn't stop her from getting pregnant.
I tried to do everything right. She was pregnant at 15.
But she can stop her from ruining her baby's life.
You have custody of him.
Yes, I do.
Now, a desperate girl fights for the right to raise her baby.
When I can get my son back.
Are teenagers fit to be mothers? On the next Montel.
Weekday mornings at 10 on Fox 11.
What's the latest fashion? Stylish casual and active apparel from your home team, Fox 11. Step out in style in t-shirts, sweatshirts, sportswear, and outerwear in a wide range of popular styles and colors, accented with this sporty embroidered Fox 11 logo. To see all the hot new Fox 11 fashions and to order yours, hit our website at www.wluk.com. Stop by Fox 11 or drop us a line and we'll send you a brochure. Sport the colors of your favorite station with casual apparel from your home team, Fox 11.
We got the faces loaded with fun. We're the Wisconsin Timber Rattlers. We got the bases loaded. Come on, give them a cheer. Plenty of fun for everyone. We got the bases loaded here. We got the bases loaded with fun. We're the Wisconsin Timber Rattlers.
We're back on Shotgun. Plenty action during the break, but the bottom line is the Quebecers are still in control.
And for the first time now, Mosh starting to show some movement. He needs to make a tag.
Mosh hammering away now. Off the ropes. Oh, there's a knee to the midsection.
Michael, I was handed this note during the break. It's from Tennessee Lee,
the promoter
of the world's greatest singer and entertainer, Double J.
Great.
The announcement reads as follows, folks. Don't forget, Double J will be performing with Sawyer Brown next Sunday at Unforgiven, Sunday, April 26th, 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific. Tennessee Lee says you don't want to miss it.
Mosh off the ropes now. Telegraph into a sunset flip.
Here we go.
Mosh should get a cover here. There's two. Kick out by Jacques Rougeau.
He didn't have Jacques' arms tied down tight. Mosh has taken a lot of punishment. Jacques capitalizing on the lower back, trying to end things right now.
You know, you're talking about Tennessee Lee. We got a treat next week on Shotgun. I understand Tennessee Lee will be joining us to do some commentary to talk about Unforgiven.
I'll tell you, this guy's a marketing genius. He doesn't miss a trick. He's doing everything in his power, including that amazing showering of leaflets throughout the Core State Center to get the word out about Double J. The word I'm thinking about right now is Sable.
That's right, the evening gown match.
Yeah, I understand there's a lot of lingerie designers that want to have their product displayed next Sunday at Unforgiven, trying to set up deals with both Sable and Luna.
Mosh in all kinds of trouble. Here's a cover now by Jacques from the Quebecers, and a save made by Thrasher.
And last week I said I'm working on a special investigative report. Michael, I've had to put that project on the back burner for right now. I'm not at liberty to talk about it. There's some legal issues, and hopefully very soon I'll be bringing forward that big story I've been working on.
And there's the headbangers down flapjack.
That should do it.
Here's the cover by Thrasher. There's two, and again, Pierre makes the save.
Every time one team has had an opportunity for a lateral press and a possible pin, the other is coming to make the save.
And the headbangers now hammering away on the Quebecers. Mosh and Thrasher,
yeah,
and there
Tim
goes
White,
the bell.
Tim White is frustrated. He's given enough warnings, and he's throwing this one out. The crowd is upset, but you know what? I don't blame him. Tim White has had enough.
We're going to have a double disqualification here. You were hit it right on the head, Kevin. Every time one team had a chance to win, outside interference.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has disqualified all four participants. This contest, a double disqualification.
You know, it's chaotic here this week, but I wonder what that Long Island street fight's going to be like Monday night on Raw.
Yeah, more of the same. Covers yard, do whatever you want to do. It's going to be wild.
And on a confrontation at the Undertaker and Kane's parents' gravesite, I don't know what that's going to be all about.
And we know that the Stone Cold Steve Austin Vince McMahon story is not over. What's Dude Love's role in this?
Why, dude, why?
Will we get the answer to that this Monday on Raw?
It's going to be unreal. I can tell you one thing, though. Things have not been settled between Vince McMahon and Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Folks, it's going to be a huge crowd inside the Nassau Coliseum.
And the headbangers of Quebec are still going at it, folks. For Kevin Kelly, I'm Michael Cole.
Join us for Raw this Monday. We'll see everybody at 8:57 Eastern.